cause is not expected for about another year. Now, more local news. The hammer is falling on students after a massive brawl at a high school after a high school football game. Fox 8's Melissa Reed is live in Garfield Heights with an update on arrests. Melissa.
Hi there, Gabe. Well, four students in the stands are now charged with disorderly conduct, and 11 students and athletes here at Garfield Heights will face punishment for their role in this fight Friday night against Collinwood. Now, one of these students under arrest is 18-year-old Daquan Winfield of Cleveland, a senior at JFK High School in Cleveland. Now, this fight all went down during the third quarter, when both benches cleared during the game between the Garfield Heights Bulldogs and Cleveland's Collinwood Railroaders. According to Garfield Heights School District, 11 students, including 7 football players, will face punishment for their involvement. The school is also going over security measures at the stadium, and Garfield Heights police will have increased presence at Friday night's game at the stadium against Bedford.
Well, those are unfortunate events, but I don't think this is the first time it's ever happened. High school events, things like this happen, you have young kids involved, and as unfortunate it is, everybody has to do their part and take their responsibility, and I think the police department and the school district did that, and that, like I said, the kids involved will have to face the consequences either through the courts or through the school.
Now, we do have some updates for you. According to the OHSAA, 2 players from both Garfield Heights and Collinwood were ejected during the game. They will now face a 1-game suspension, so a total of 4 players will not play at their respective games on Friday. Also, according to the OHSAA, the final score for the game was 26-6, with the win going to Garfield Heights. That was the score in the third quarter when that fight all went down. Gabe, two councilmen, Palencic as well as Jeff Johnson, they want results and they want punishment for the players in Collinwood that were involved in this. They said they've asked the school to open an investigation as well as the school district so that those players are held accountable for their actions as well.
And again, Melissa, do we really know what started this here? Was this just kind of a trash talking gone too far? What really started it all?
Well, according to police, a lot of this started in the stands. There were fights in the stands prior to what actually happened on the ball field. But on the football field, it was what they were calling a cheap shot, a late hit in the third quarter. I know the kicker was involved as well per that video on YouTube. But whatever it was should never have led to what happened there on the football field. That's for sure.
All right. Melissa Reed, live with the latest in Garfield Heights. Thanks so much.